Hey there, everyone. It's excessively hot here. It's 45 degrees and it's too hot for me to accurately convert that into Fahrenheit for you. I'm not going to embarrass myself trying. Just trust me, it's very hot here. This week's topic is what has surprised us since coming out. I have a very long list of things that have surprised me. Don't worry, I'm not going to bore you with all of them. I'll just stick to the main ones. I think the number one thing that has surprised me the most is the number of people that have changed their minds. It's surprising just wandering through everyday life as I do, and I'm sure we all probably do, watching people change their minds. What totally has blown me away is people with a really high public profile, especially politicians, who blatantly have changed their minds. It's really rare to see people with those kind of public profiles to just suddenly go, "Oh, I got that wrong. I think differently now." Like, that is rare. That does not happen. And it has happened so much in the last few years. It's wonderful. And I actually wish that it would happen on more issues than just the LGBT issue. It is really refreshing to hear people just come out and go, "I think differently about this now because I have this information and I've seen X, Y, and Z." But yeah, it has been really surprising to see that. And I think the other thing that's really surprised me is marriage equality around the world. And okay, it's every developed nation except Australia. But hey, it still surprises me. It really, maybe that won't surprise me once we have marriage equality here, but it really does surprise me. It still blows my mind. I never thought I would see it in my lifetime. It equally surprises me that Australia is behaving like they don't belong to the world. A lot of the things that I thought before I came out turned out to be completely untrue. Another thing, oh, look, I won't keep going, but one of the things I just quickly will say is I had this understanding that most people that were actively against, and I'm not talking about people who just haven't been around it, but most people who were actively against LGBT people, it was because they were uneducated, they didn't have the accurate information, it was based a fear based on ignorance, and that's what I thought. And as it turns out, yes, those people exist, and as I said, on a more positive note, so many people have changed their mind, which is wonderful. But what I discovered about the people that are actively anti is the same as people who fear everything. And I don't know that this is just a realization about being LGBT, it's a realization about life in general, is that people are most afraid of the things they have the capacity of. And that's not to suggest they will do those things, but people's greatest fears are often the things that they know they have the capacity to be. And I see this with a lot of things, and it comes down to that very raw thing. Like, that's probably why we're all so afraid of violence, because we all know we have the capacity to be violent. We choose not to be. That, and I'm not suggesting, that just because we have the capacity, we're going to run out there and exercise it, but that primal fear lives in that knowledge of that capacity. And it's very similar with LGBT people. People who actively go out of their way are not what I thought. They're not the people that just haven't had the right information or haven't known the right people, or their fear is not based on ignorance. It's based on their knowledge of their own capacity. And that really surprised me. That's just not what I thought at all. Anyway, I promised I'd keep the list short, right? have a wonderful weekend, and I'll see you next week. Bye for now.